Good evening. Welcome to St. Joan of Arc. This has been a pretty amazing experience. It's been working with 3K through 8th grade, about 50 kids, putting this performance together. I can't tell you how proud I am of the kids. I want to welcome all of you, and I hope you enjoy the show. So sit back and relax and have fun. Thank you.
She says it's all day long. Thank you. said that? Don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows don't talk.
It's Pleasant down that way, too.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Of course people do go both ways.
Well, you did say something, didn't you? Are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
That's the trouble. I can't make up my mind. I haven't got a brain.
I'm a straw.
Well, how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
I don't know, but people without brains do talk an awful lot.
Yes, I guess you're right. Well, we really haven't met properly, have we?
Why, no.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Very well, thank you.
Oh, I'm not well at all. It's very tedious being stuck up here all day with a cold in your back.
Oh dear, that must be very uncomfortable. Can't you get down?
Well, no.
Oh, here, let me help you with that.
Oh, that's very kind of you. Very kind.
Oh dear, I don't see how I can.
Of course, I'm not very great about things, but maybe if you just bend the nails in the back.
Oh, yes. Oh dear, are you all right?
Ha, there goes some of me again.
Oh, does it hurt you?
Oh no, I just keep picking it back up and putting it back in again.
Oh,
my, it's good to be free.
Oh dear, did I scare you?
No,
did I scare you?
No, of course not.
I just thought you hurt yourself.
Oh, I didn't think so. Oh, I'm a failure because I haven't got a brain.
Well, what would you do with a brain if you had one?
Do? Well, if I had a brain, I could. I could all the way the hours, compare it with the flowers, consult them with the rain. With my head, I could stretch, and while my thoughts were busy hatching, if I only had a brain.
Two eyes?
Two
that's a long and dangerous journey, and it might rain on the way.
But you've been saying how much you've wanted a heart,
and I'll keep the old cane handy.
Well, suppose the wizard wouldn't give me one when we got there.
Oh, he will! He must! We've come such a long way already. To Oz?
To Oz. What's that?
Come such a long way. Why, you've just begun. Forgot about me, eh? Well, I have forgot about you. Tell me, my fine lady, along with you, my fine gentleman. Well, stay away from her, or I'll stab a match with you, and you, I'll turn you into a beehive. Scarecrow, wanna play ball? That's for you, Dorothy. I wish you luck with the Wizard of Oz, and a happy journey back to Kansas.
I'll see you reach the wizard whether I get a heart. Make a beehive out of me. Bah.
Oh, you two are the best of friends anyone could ever have. Although I feel like it's like I've known you all along. But I couldn't have. Could I? Well, you weren't with me when I was stuffed and sewn together, were you? No.
I was standing over there rusting for the longest time.
Still, I wish I could remember. But I guess it doesn't matter now anyway. We know each other now, don't we?
That's right.
We do.
Two Oz?
Two Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. You'll find he is a wiz, a wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, ever a wiz there was, the wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does.
I'm out of him and fur.
I be gentle as a lizard.
I be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is the wizard of the sun,
then I'm sure to get a brain,
a heart. Help! Help!
Don't! It's not as screaming in a town like this! Nobody will hear
helps that girl, but shoes are no shoes. My power's great enough to conquer her, and woe to those who try to stop me.
Look, there's Emerald City. It's closer and prettier than ever. Come on, let's get out of here.
Guys. My heel, all the trees would kneel, and the mountains bow, and the mountains bow.
You were king of the forest? You wouldn't be afraid of anybody?
Not knowing, not know how!
Well, what if you met, an elephant?
Well, I'd wrap him up in cellophane!
How about a hippopotamus?
I'd brush him from top to bottom.
How about a rhinoceros?
Imposterous!
What about a brontosaurus?
I'd show him who was king of the forest.
How?
How? What makes a king out of a slave? Courage! What makes a flag out of a masquerade? Courage! What makes an elephant charge his past into the misty mist of a dusky dust?
Courage!
What makes a muskrat guard his mouth?
Courage!
What makes a sphinx the seventh wonder?
Courage!
What makes a dog roar like thunder?
Courage!
What makes a hot stick so hot?
Courage!
What was the eighth and angry thought?
Courage!
What if they got that I don't got?
Courage!
You said that again.
Go on home. The wizard says, go away.
Go away?
Oh, it looks like we came a long way for nothing. Oh, and I thought I was going home. Oh, Aunt Sam was so good to me, and I never appreciated it. Running away and hurting her feelings. Oh, and Professor Marvel said she was sick. Oh, she could be dying right now. And it's all my fault. I'll never forgive myself. Never, never, never.
Oh, please don't cry anymore. I'll get you into the wizard somehow. Come on, I had Nancy and myself once.
Oh, thank you.
Clanking, clattering collection of collisionist junk?
Yes, Your Honor. Yes, Your Majesty. You see, a while back, we were walking down the Yellowwood Road.
And you, Scarecrow, have the effrontery to ask for a brain, you billowing bale of bovine fodder.
Yes, Your Majesty. I mean Your Majesty. I mean Your Honor.
No. And you, liar. Silence, whippersnapper. The beneficiaries has every intention of granting a request.
What did he say? What did he say?
But first, you must prove yourselves worthy by performing a very small task. Bring me the broomstick of the Witch of the West.
But to do that, we have to kill her to get it.
Bring me your broomstick and I'll grant your requests. Now go.
But what if she kills us first?
I said go.
Oh.
you all over, isn't it?
They really had to suck this out of you, didn't they?
Oh, don't stand there talking! Fix me up!
What a nice little dog we'll have here. So nice of you to visit me in my loneliness.
What are you going to do with my dog? Give him back!
Certainly, certainly. Won't you give me out those slippers?
But the gunner to the north told me not to.
Very well, I will throw him into the river and drown him.
No, you can't have this slipper. Just give me back Toto.
That's a good little girl. I knew you'd see the reason.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do it. Can I still have my dog back?
No. Fool that I am, I should remember. Those shoes will never come off as long as you're alive.
What are you going to do to me?
What do you think I'm going to do? It's how to. These things must be done delicately, or you hurt spell. See that? That's how strong you've got us to live. It isn't long, my little pretty, it isn't long. Can't wait forever to get those shoes.
Oh, don't worry about me, guys. It's Dorothy we gotta worry about.
Well, how are we gonna find her?
I've got a plan.
Fine, he's got a plan.
And you're gonna lead
it. Me?
Yes, oh, you.
I gotta get her out there.
That's right. Go away! You've had enough time already!
Do not arouse the wrath of great and powerful eyes. I said come back tomorrow.
If you're really great and powerful, you keep your promises.
Do you presume to criticize the great Oz, you ungrateful creatures? Think yourselves lucky that I'm giving the audience tomorrow instead of 20 years from now. The great Oz is so.
Who are you?
I pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. Go, before I lose my temper. The great and powerful Oz is spoken.
Who are you?
Well, I am the great and powerful Wizard of Oz.
You humble! Yeah!
Yes, that is so. I am a humble.
Oh, you're a very bad man.
No, I'm a very good man. I'm just a very bad wizard.
Well, you better be good enough to bring Dorothy back to Kansas.
No, please don't yell at me. It makes me nervous.
Nervous?
Yes.
Well, what about the heart you promised the Tin Man?
Yeah.
And the courage you promised the Lion.
And Scarecrow's brain.
Well, you've had them. You've had them the entire time.
Oh, no, we haven't.
You don't get around us that easy.
Not go out.
Yeah.
Why anyone can have a brain? Well, that's a very mediocre commodity. Back where I come from, we have universities, where men go to become great thinkers, and they come out with one thing you haven't got, a diploma. Therefore, by the authority vested in me, hereby declare upon you the honorary degree of Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
Yes, that's Doctor of, Thinkology.
The sum of square roots of any two sides of the assassin's triangle are equal to the square root of the remaining side. Joy! Literature! I've got a brain! How can I ever thank you enough?
Well, you can't. As for you, Lion, you are under the unfortunate delusion that just because you run away from fear, that you have no courage. Back where I come from, we have men who are called heroes, and have no more courage than you have. Therefore, for meritorious conduct, I award you the Medal of Courage.
Oh, Shumpsmokes, I'm speechless!
As for you, Tin Man, you want a heart. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be made useful until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Yes, that may be so. Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing all day but good deeds. They are called, good deed doers. They have no more heart than you have. But that one thing you haven't got, a testimonial.
Hey, Dix, listen.
Oh, yes!
Oh dear, I don't think we have anything in the black bag for me.
Well, on the contrary, Dorothy, you've had the way back the entire time.
Really?
Yes, all you had to do was click your heels three times and say, there's no place like home.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Once in a lullaby.
you everyone so much. Thank you so much for coming to our show today. How about another huge round of applause? Off to prepare the show for you today and done just a phenomenal job. We are so very proud of them. And there has been a bunch of help to help make that happen, beginning with our assistant directors, and I'd like to introduce them to you and bring them out for a little thank you. Mr. Opichka. Mrs. McAvoy. Working with our music, Mrs. Leisha Smith. This year, Mrs. Colleen Hernandez. Again, one more huge round of applause for our cast.